going to be the three stages of Christ's sacrifice for us.
All right.
We're doing the death, the burial, and the resurrection.
All right.
And so, of course, we're going to start with death. And really what I just want you guys to think about today is, I think a lot of times we think about Christ's death as such a sad thing. And it is, but I think the thing we overlook is that nobody took his life from
him. Amen. Come on,
he gave it.
Amen.
And so that, not that he died is a joyful thing, but the reason that he died, and that's because of his intense love for us.
Once believed that love was romance, just a chance. I even thought that love was for the lucky. Once believed that love was a momentary bliss, but love is more than this. For all you ever wanted was my attention. All you ever wanted was love from me. All you ever wanted was my affections. To sit here at your feet and tell me, what does love look like? Is the question I've been pondering. What does love look like? If all of life comes down to love, then tell me, what does love look like? Is the question I've been pondering. What does love look like? Then I sat down, a little frustrated and confused. If all of life comes down to love, then love has to be more than sentiment, more than selfishness and selfish gain. And then I saw him there, hanging on a tree, looking at me. Saw him there, hanging on a tree, looking at me. He was looking at me, looking at him, staring through me. I could not escape those beautiful eyes, and I began to weep. Wide open, heart exposed, arms wide open, he was bleeding. And as I sat there, weeping, crying, those beautiful eyes, full of desire and love, and he said to me, you shall love me, you shall love me, you shall love, you shall love me, you shall love. This is how I know what love is. This is how I know what love is.
You know what it is? I love it.
You can read it in my bar. I'm pretty straight fire when I'm speaking about my lard. He paid the sin price being beat by Roman guard. But when he resurrected, gave us life free of charge. Now me and my bud need to be in a psych ward. Cause we went crazy for God, our lives were scarred. Now when the book of life, our names have been written down. We're casting our crowns before his feet on the ground.
His own glory that he gives to us the most prized and priceless gift, namely himself. Jesus Christ, the God-man, comes to earth to establish his kingdom in the hearts of people that they may enjoy for eternity the ultimate pleasure, the worship of a good and holy God. One day all the saints will dwell with our triune God in New Jerusalem, the capital city of heaven, and he will wipe away every tear from our eyes. And death shall be no more. Neither shall there be any mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. For the former things will pass away. And he who was seated on the throne said, "Behold, I am making all things new."
So, this next song that we're going to do, it's called "I've Got a River." And it just talks about how, you know, we have the Holy Spirit. And so, just all throughout Scripture, Christ is talking about how, you know, he compares the Holy Spirit to living water, and Amen. This is what we have, and it's amazing.
Amen. Amen. Makes the blind see. I've got a river of life flowing out of me, and it makes the lame to walk and the blind to see. I'm so